I'm making this video for a guy named Woods of Jordan. I've only partly heard this story. I'm actually a subscriber of Voodoo 6. And Voodoo 6 did a short clip saying that Woods of Jordan is converting now to Mormonism, or to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, otherwise known as LDS. And he's wondering how this could take place because he had become rational enough to see that there wasn't enough evidence for even the belief in God, that he had become what he had called himself as an agnostic atheist. I have some insight into this, and even though I don't know the guy, and I want to share with you a little bit about my insight into this, and I want to tell Woods of Jordan what he's getting into in terms of the esoteric doctrines of the Mormon Church, what they won't explicitly tell you, and sometimes will even lie to you about when directly asked. How do I know about this stuff? In the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, there are many doctrines which you would classify as exoteric. They're public relations friendly doctrines which they will come out and discuss with anybody freely. But there are also esoteric doctrines. There are parts of the religion which are not discussed openly. There are even parts of the religion which, when you receive them, if you come to receive them, you swear an oath upon your life that you will not reveal them. And how do I know all of this stuff? I was raised a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints in a line of firstborn sons to the early pioneers. This may be the only way that you truly get the picture from members of the church as to what the doctrine is really all about. First, before I go into that, I want to explain why someone would be able to give up the rational side of their thinking and convert to this church. The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints has a really ingenious way of getting people to brainwash themselves into believing this stuff. What happens is the emotional side of the brain cannot distinguish between fact and fiction. Were it not so, you wouldn't watch emotional movies because they wouldn't touch you. You would distinguish that they were fictional and it wouldn't bother you. The emotional side of the brain has the emotional response to fictitious stimuli because it doesn't understand the difference between what's real and what's not. What happens in proselyting for the church is that you get the person to whip themselves up into an emotional state by pouring their heart out before God. You want them to come into a very sincere, heartfelt, prayerful state, praying before God whether this stuff is true. And when you have an emotional breakthrough where you have an emotional response from that side of your brain that can't distinguish between fact and fiction, this is what you are told is the Holy Ghost telling you that it's true. So what the praying person then does is he then tells himself that God himself told him that this stuff is true. And then he has his own witness in which he bases his belief on. So instead of relying on a mere faith, as most modern Christian-type religions will do, they say that they have knowledge that this stuff is true. If you ask a member about their testimony, it won't be one of faith. It will be one of, I know this is true. And the reason they know this stuff is true is because they've had this emotional response after this sincere and heartfelt prayerful state, which they then convince themselves came from God himself. And because their emotional brain can't distinguish between fact and fiction, they take that as reality. Now that being said, that is how a lot of people get converted to the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. That's how a lot of people become Mormons, because they, even though they may be very rational thinkers, they can draw from atheists and stuff in this way, because they give up the rational side of their thinking and this process when they give over to opening their heart to the Holy Ghost as they see it. Now that being said, I want to go into the esoteric doctrine so that Woods of Jordan and other people looking into the church will know intellectually, at least, what is really there behind the surface in the doctrines of the church. And perhaps when you know just how insane the doctrine really is, then you'll be able to rethink on a rational level how this stuff should be considered. Even though normally this is esoteric doctrine and they won't talk about it openly, there are references to it in their canon of scripture.